Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about order Coleoptera. The class Insecta includes some of the biggest insect orders, among which the order Lepidoptera, which includes beetles and weevils, stands first. This is followed by order Lepidoptera, which includes the moths and butterflies. Coleoptera includes beetles and weevils. The name Coleoptera is derived from the Greek word koleos, means sheath, and ptera means wings, which refers to the modified front wings, which serve as a protective covering for the membranous hind wings. They are found in terrestrial habitats. A few beetles are aquatic, many feed on decaying plant and animals. The forewings are modified into an horny helitra, which almost meet to form a straight mid-dorsal suture. In some cases, the forewings are soldered together, especially in the ground beetles. They are folded beneath the elytra. Prothorax is usually large and mobile. The mesothorax is reduced. Metamorphosis is complete. The larvae are campodiform. Hypermetamorphosis is seen especially in the blister beetles, wherein more than one larval forms can be observed. Identification of Coleopteran insects. Coleoptera are endopterygoton neoptera, and mandibulate mouthparts are often seen. The forewings are hardened, not folded, rigid elytra which usually meet edge to edge in a straight line when at rest, and partly or wholly cover the hind wings and the abdomen. The hind wings are usually well developed. Most often they are kept folded under the forewings during rest, and they are the only wings used for flight. Prothorax is often well developed, almost always free, and it forms with the head a distinct forebody, which is contrasting with the hind body, which consists of mesothorax, metathorax, and the abdomen. Abdominal sternites are very heavily sclerotized, and the tergites are membranous. Larvae are with or without thoracic legs, but with a distinct head capsule, antenna, mouthparts, and rarely with abdominal prolegs. These lack the crochets. The pupae are adductious and exarrate, and they are rarely optic type. Coming to habit and habitat of Coleopteran insects, Coleoptera is the largest order of the insects and about 40% of all insects, and 30% of all animals are Coleopteran insects, that is beetles and weevils. They are much varied in their habits. Some are herbivorous, feeding on almost all parts of the plants, acting as leaf miners, gall makers, defoliators, flower bud, fruit and nut borers, stem borers, root borers, and seed feeders. They are also pests in storage, affecting grains, textiles, and as museum pests affect the hides, horns of animals, etc. Many species are predaceous, particularly Carabidae, tiger beetles, Gyrinidae, Dytiscidae, and some Hydrophilidae, etc. are voracious predators. Some coccinellate predators are used in biological control of crop pests. There are a few parasites also, especially the species of Mardelidae and Ripiporidae. A few species of beetles and weevils act as pollinators of specific species of plants. Most important service provided by some groups of beetles is recycling of organic matter, especially of animal origin, like dung of ruminants. In fact, the sacred scarab beetle was worshipped as sun god by the Egyptians. A few species under family Meloidae are used for extracting chemicals, that is cantharidin, which are of medical importance. Light production in some groups of beetles is observed in Lamphyridae and Elateridae, which has attracted the attention of many scientists, and also the common man have been exploited for tourism. The elytra of jewel beetles have been used in making ornaments. The beetles and weevils are widely spread in all geographical regions of the world. They have successfully exploited both aquatic and terrestrial habits and habitats. They are also found on vegetation, in caves, soil, and on the decaying animal and plant material. Some habitats from where one can collect beetles are the dung, leaf litter, mushrooms, dead animals, dead and fallen logs in flowers, especially belonging to Asteraceae and Umbelliferae plants. The economic importance of coleopteran insects. This group is of great importance as it includes many pest species of crops, forests and horticultural plants. They attack all parts of living plants as well as processed fibers, grains and wood products. The mango nut weevil Sternocytus mangiferae has prevented the export of whole mangoes to some countries. The cotton weevil Anthonomus grandis is a serious quarantine pest. Several borers, including coffee white stem borer Xylotrichus quadripes, are of great threat for horticultural crop as there are not many options for their effective management. Predatory Coccinellidae, especially Rhodelia cardinalis and Icaria purchasi, have helped to save crops, and scavengers like Scarabaeidae have made earth habitable and are useful as decomposers and recyclers of organic nutrients. The life cycle of coleopteran insects. Beetles have a complete life cycle, and development may take anywhere from a few weeks to several years. Eggs are usually laid on or near the food source, such as in the soil or on a host plant, depending upon the species. The number of eggs laid will depend upon the species and may range from 1 or 2 up to hundreds. After hatching, the larvae develop through a series of growth stages known as instars. Usually 3 to 5 instars are observed before they pupate and enter into adult stage. Larvae with or without thoracic legs but with distinct head capsule, antenna, mouth parts and rarely with abdominal prolegs. These lack the crochets and head is well developed with ocelli and chewing mouth parts. The body form. They are campodiform, slender, active crawlers. If it is Scarabiform, they are grub-like, fleshy, C-shaped body. Elateriform larvae are usually called wireworms. They are elongate, cylindrical with a hard exoskeleton and tiny legs. Pupa. Pupa are adactitious, that is mandibles immovably attached to the head and exudate. Rarely they are obtect type. Some heteropteran bugs resemble beetles but have sectorial mouth parts. Coming to adults, in adults the prothorax is well developed, almost always free with the head forms a distinct forebody, contrasting with the hind body which consists of mesothorax, metathorax and abdomen. Abdominal sternites are very heavily sclerotized and the pterygoids are membranous. Chewing mouth parts in the weevils, the front of the head is drawn out into a snout and mouth parts are at the end. The front wings or elytra are hard and serve as covers for the hind wings and meet in a line in the middle of the back. The hind wings are large, membranous, folded beneath the elytra. Tarsi are 2 to 5 segmented. Some salient features of the coleopteran insects. Coleoptera is the largest order in the animal kingdom. It includes 40% of all insects and nearly 30% of all animal species. The smallest beetle is the fringed ant beetle, Nanocella fungi. The family to which it belongs is Tilidae. At 0.25 mm in length, and it is some 16 million times smaller in volume than the largest beetle called as the Goliathus giganteus, which belongs to the family Scarabaeidae, which may have a body length of up to 10 centimeters. Two families of Coleoptera are bioluminescent. They are able to produce light, that is fireflies, which belong to the family Lampyridae, and glowworms, which belong to the family Fengodidae. They have light producing organs in the abdomen. In some species, the females are wingless and larviform. Ancient Egyptians believed that a scarab beetle rolled the sun across the sky each day. The scarab icon being associated with Ra, the sun god, and scarab beetle Scarabaeus sacer were worshipped as a symbol of immortality. Over 1000 beetle species are known to live as predators, parasites or commensals in the nests of ants. They gain entrance to the nest by mimicking the odor and behavior of the ants. Bombardier beetles, especially the Brachyna species under family Carabidae, have the ability to discharge a defensive spray of hot quinones. Two chemical reactants are stored in adjacent compartments of an abdominal gland, and they combine explosively when the insect is disturbed. The males of many stag beetles, that is family Leucanidae, and scarab beetles under family Scarabaeidae, have enlarged mandibles or protruding horns which are used in courtship and in ritualized fights with other males. Cryptonephridial condition in beetles. It is an arrangement of the excretory system in certain beetles in which the distal blind endings of the malpighian tubules are held against the wall of the rectum by a perinephric membrane. A high concentration of ions is established in the tubules, which draws water from the gut by osmosis. This creates a highly efficient mechanism for conservation of water in the species, such as mealworms, which feed on dry material. Coming to collection and preservation of coleopteran insects, this is a very large group with varied habit and habitat. Hence, the different methods used for collection of insects may be also used, such as sweeping on the vegetation and flowers, baited traps at light, extracting from the debris and leaf litter using burley's funnel, wood and bark aquatic nests, etc. For preservation of adult stages, pin through the right elytra or mount on the card points by gluing onto the right side of the thorax. Classification of Coleoptera. The first suborder is Adipaga. Here the wing venation usually is with oblongum. They have the first visible abdominal sternite divided by the fixed backwardly projected metathoracic coxae. Notopleural suture visible on the lateroventral sides of the thorax. The tarsal segments are 5, 5 and 5. Both terrestrial, land, aquatic forms and mostly predaceous. Larvae are both terrestrial and aquatic. Under that family 1, that is Scarabaeidae or ground beetles, here the head includes eyes narrower than the pronotum. Clypeus is not extended laterally in front of antennal insertions. Elytra is often with longitudinal grooves or rows of punctures. Adults and larvae are predaceous. They live under the stones, logs, leaves, barks, etc. They run rapidly when they are disturbed and they rarely fly. Example, Anthea sex guttata. The second family is Cicindelidae or tiger beetles. They are brightly colored and metallic beetles with long slender legs. They actively run or fly when disturbed and they frequent sunlit spots in sandy areas. The head is wider than pronotum. Elytra is without longitudinal grooves. The clypeus produced laterally beyond bases of the antenna. Mandibles are long, sickle-shaped and toothed. The larvae live in vertical burrows in sandy soil and wait for their prey. Example is Cicindela sex punctata. Family third, that is Dieticidae or predaceous diving beetles. These are usually elongate, oval, convex and streamlined. Hind legs are flattened and fringed with hairs. The antenna is thread-like and longer than maxillary palpi. Both adults and larvae are aquatic and predaceous. Suborder Acrostemata. It is a small group which has notopleural suture on prothorax, but the first visible abdominal sternite is not divided. The hind wings have the distal part spirally rolled in repose. Larvae are terrestrial. Family Micromalthidae, Cupididae. Under suborder 3, that is Myxophaga, their prothorax is with notopleural suture. The hind wings are folded in the basal half and rolled apically. Larvae are aquatic. The families are Tauridincolidae and Hydroscalpidae. Suborder 4 is Polyphaga. Their wings are without oblongum. The notopleural suture is not visible. First visible abdominal sternite is not divided. Metathoracic coxae are movable. Tarsi will be variable. Adults and larvae are varied in their habits. The fourth family is Staphylinidae, otherwise called as row beetles. These are nearly always elongate, slender and parallel sided. Four wings are short and exposed. Three or five are abdominal segments. Abdomen is flexible, often bent upwards. Adults and larvae are predaceous or saprophytic. Example, Staphylinus Caesareus. The fifth family is Scarabaeidae, or they are otherwise called chaffer beetles or root grubs. They are oval or elongate, usually stout and heavy bodied, varying greatly in form and size. They have 8 to 11 segmented antenna. The lamellate segments of the club capable of being held tight together. The front tibia is brown, flat, provided with teeth on the other edge. Tip of the abdomen is often exposed, called as pygidium. Larvae of Scarabiforum are saprophytic or phytophagous. The next subfamily, that is Cetoninae, which includes rose chaffers or flower beetles. Here the body of the beetles is flattened. Lateral margins of elytra are usually with a shallow emargination behind the humeri. The size and color are variable. Elytra is truncate apically and do not cover entire abdomen. The hind leg coxae is widely separated. Example, Oxycetonia versicolor, which feeds on anther and corolla. Subfamily Dynastinae or rhinoceros beetle, here the front coxae is transverse, body is usually convex above, mandibles are bent, expanded and leaf-like. Lateral margin of elytra is without a shallow emargination. Males have tubercles or horn or head and depressions on the thorax. Larvae live on decaying organic matter. Adults bore into palms and other monocotyledonous plants. The example is Oryctes rhinoceros, which is otherwise called coconut rhinoceros beetle. Subfamily Melalanthinae, which includes June beetles, chaffers and white grubs. Here the hind leg tibia is without apical spur. Tarsal claws on hind legs are usually bifid. Clypeus is not emarginated laterally and labium is sclerotized. Generally, only one pair of abdominal spiracles are exposed below the edges of the elytra. They are phytophagous. Larvae usually feed on roots of the grasses and other plants, and adults usually feed on leaves and flowers. Holotrichia serrata is the example. Subfamily Rutilinae are shining leaf chaffers. Here the hind tibia of the hind leg will have two apical spurs. Many are brightly colored. They resemble Melalanthinae but differ with respect to the mobile tarsal claws. Unequal outer claws are larger. Papilio japonica is the species. Subfamily Scarabaeinae are dung beetles. The hind tibiae will have one apical spur. The pygidium is partly exposed. Midcoxae is widely separated. Fore tarsi is reduced or absent and mandibles are reduced, incapable of biting. The example is Anthophagus species. The sixth family is Buprestidae. They are usually called as metallic wood borers or jewel beetles. They are neatly always metallic or bronze colored, especially on the ventral surface. They are hard bodied, body is elongate and oval. The prothorax is swollen, head is short, sunken in the thorax. First two visible abdominal sterna are fused together partly. Larvae with anterior end expanded or flattened bore in beneath the bark of various trees and shrubs. Example, Spinoptera gossypii. Seventh family is Elateridae or click beetles. Adults are elongate, rounded at the end, brownish or blackish in color. Posterior corners of pronotum are prolonged backwards into sharp points or spines. Antennae are usually serrate. Adult jumps into the air when placed on their backs with clicking noise. Pronotum with an elongate leg extending posteriorly. Larvae are slender, shiny. They are called wireworms. They are phytophagous, saprophytic or sometimes predaceous. Example, Cardiophorus quadrimaculatus. The eighth family is Dermistidae or Dermistid beetles. They are small, elongate or oval, convex, hairy or scaly beetles with short clubbed antenna. Hairs on the body form patterns of white or bricked or bricrete. The median ocelli is present on the front. Larvae with backwardly directed, segmentally arranged long setae. Larvae damage leather, fur, museum specimens, woolen goods, silk and stored products. Example is Atagenus fasciatus and Trogoderma granarium. The family 9 is Coccinellidae, commonly called ladybird beetles. they are broadly oval to nearly spherical convex dorsally, nearly flat ventrally. Head is partly or completely covered by pronotum. Tarsi of the leg is pseudotrimerous. It is actually 4-4-4. They are often brightly colored, yellow, orange or reddish with black margins or black with yellow to reddish markings. Antenna is short. It is a club with 3 to 6 segmented. Larvae are Campodiform. Both larvae and adults are predaceous on soft-bodied insects and mites. Some species, that is family Epilactinae, are phytophagous. Example, Chylomenus sexmaculatus, Enos Epilacna viginti octopunctata. The 10th family is Tenebrionidae or darkling beetles. The antenna is usually 11 segmented, the thread-like, bead-like or slightly clubbed arising beneath the frontal ridge. Tarsi of the leg is 5-5-4 and it is heteromerous. Generally, they are dull black or brown, sometimes they are red. Eyes are often emarginated, both adults and larvae are phytophagous. Example, Tribolium castaneum, that is red floor beetle, and Gonocephalum of Manseggi. The 11th family is Meloidae or blister beetles, usually elongate, slender, pronotum is narrower than forewing, head is broad, they are usually wider than the pronotum. The body is soft, often leathery, forewings are loosely covering the abdomen and rarely shortened. Tarsi of the leg is 5-5-4, claws with long appendage beneath. They undergo hypermetamorphosis. Larvae are predaceous on the eggs of grasshoppers or larvae of the bees, adults found on which they feed. Example is Zonabris pustulata. The 12th family is Cerambycidae or long-horned beetles. Antenna is nearly very long, always at least half or as long as the body, and often it is longer. They are capable of being fixed over the body. The scape is almost 5 times as long as the pedicel. They are born on a frontal prominence. Tarsi is pseudo-tetramerous, but it is actually 5-5-5. All tibia have got 2 spurs. Larvae are wood borers of trees and shrubs. Example is Xylotrechus quadripus, which is the coffee white stem borer, and Batocera rufomaculata, which is the mango stem borer. The 13th family is Brucidae, commonly called as seed beetles or pulse beetles. Here the body is oval or egg-shaped. They are broadcast posteriorly. Head is concealed from above, prolonged into a short, broad snout. Antenna is clubbed or serrate, sometimes pectinate. Elytra is short, exposing the tip of abdomen. They are black or brown, often mottled with patches of whitish or brownish pubescence. Larvae feed inside the seeds of legumes, pupation inside the seeds. Example is Calasobrucus chinensis. 14th family is Chrysomidae, often called as leaf beetles. Antenna nearly always less than half as long as body and not capable of being flexed over the abdomen at rest. Tarsi of the leg is 5-5-5. Body is generally oval, eyes are usually not notched. Hind leg tibia is without spurs, adults and larvae are phytophagous. Dicladispa armigera, which is the paddy hispa, is the example. 15th family is Curculionidae. They are commonly called weevils. It is the largest family under order Coleoptera. The head is prolonged into a well-developed snout. Antenna is clubbed, geniculate and arise midway on the snout. Palps are small and rigid, often concealed in the mouth. Larvae are apodous or legless with well-developed head. They are usually phytophagous. Milloceras discolor is the example. 16th family is Coleoptidae or bark beetles or Ambrosia beetles. They are elongate, cylindrical, head is visible dorsally or it is concealed. Tarsi are short, first segment is not elongate. The antenna is usually elbowed and clubbed. They are brownish to black, small beetles causing short holes on the shoots of plants. Legless larvae feed on the Ambrosia fungi cultivated by the adults in the galleries. Example is Xyloborus morsati, which is coffee short hole borer. 17th family is Lampyridae, commonly called as fireflies. They are elongate, soft-bodied, pronotum extends forward over the head is concealed. Antenna is relatively short. They have got luminescent organs which are capable of producing light. Luminescent organs are located on 5th or on the 5th and 6th segments in males or on the 7th segment in females. There will be synchronous flashing of the light. Larvae are predaceous on snails and slugs. Eighteenth family is Anobiidae or death watch beetle, that is the common name. They are cylindrical or oval, reddish or dark brown. Head is concealed by large pronotum. Body is covered by hairs. Hind coxal cavity is deep. They are destructive pests of stored products. Example is the drugstore beetle, scientifically called as Stygobium panaceum. The 19th family is Bostrichidae. They are called twig borers. They are elongate, cylindrical, head is bent down. Surface of pronotum is usually with elytra rugose. Antenna is having less than 11 segments and the last three form a club. Elytra is flat and sculptured, body is truncated. Larvae are wood borers on stored grains. Rhizoportha dominica is the example. The 20th family is Lictidae or powder post beetles. They are slender, elongate, reddish brown beetles. Pronotum is flattened, head is prominent from above, antenna is having 11 segments with 2 segments clubbed. Their parallel sided body is distinct. They cause small tiny holes in the wood. Lictus bruneus is often found in freshly cut and old timber or furniture. Some of the coccinellids have been successfully used in biological control, that is Cryptolemus montrosieri, which was imported from Australia to California in 1892 for the effective suppression of mealybugs on grapevine. These beetles are having very high fecundity. They lay about 200 eggs and they have been very successful in the biological control of Tucra mealybug on mulberry, that is Meconelicoccus hirsutus, and Gova mealybug Chloropulmonaria sidi. They are recommended at the field release rate of 2500 to 3000 beetles per hectare. Rhodelia cardinalis is another coccinellid beetle which has been successfully used in Australia since 1888 for the control of cottony cushion scale Iceria purchasi. It has been imported into India, Japan and United States. And this beetle also has got high fecundity. It can lay somewhere between 800 to 1000 eggs.